Tell me we're friends.
We're not friends.
All right. Well, then tell me we're like pseudo-friends, like in that gray area between acquaintance and friends where, you know, sometimes we share a laugh.
Look, friends don't take 10%. Now, is this why you came over here?
No, but you might say we're friends after I tell you why I'm here.
So why are you here?
Your star continues to rise. And while you know I've brought you plenty of deals in the past, brace yourself for the big one. It's time to create your signature shoe.
Oh!
Are we friends now?
No, but we definitely moving in that right direction, man. Hey, I'm super pumped. It's about time. So when we get started?
Right now, man.
Yo, what's up, everybody, and welcome to the Grindhouse, home of Marc Gasol, Zach Randolph, and the Memphis Grizzlies. Today, my matchup is Mike Conley at the point guard spot, and Conley's going to be a challenge to guard, try to make sure he doesn't go off himself, try to make sure he doesn't control the pace of the game. That's the main thing when you guard Conley's. We get the steal on Gasol here, double team him. I'm calling for the ball. I want to oop it up to Bogut over Conley. No way he's stopping that, and we got a beautiful transition lob right there. But yeah, Mike Conley, his main thing is controlling the pace. Make sure he doesn't get the ball into the post too much to his guys as we take a three at the end of the shot clock. Don't get it to go. So yeah, that's what we're going to try to do as Conley pulls up that shot there. Doesn't get it to go. We got a late contest on that one. We're starting a fast break. And the last thing we want to do is get fast break buckets. We put Randolph in the air, pull up the jumper, but don't get it to go. Because the Grizzlies half-court defense is as good as any team in the NBA. When you're talking about Conley, you're talking about Gasol, you're talking about Tony Allen. Not many passing lanes and stuff like that. So we're going to try to get things going as Steph Curry pulls up the jump shot there, gets it to go. Curry off the bench, getting that run to knock down as Klay Thompson also in the game. For this game, for whatever reason, the coach left Curry and Thompson in the game, which I am definitely okay with, man. I definitely like lineups where Steph's playing shooting guard and Thompson's playing small forward. I wish we did it more often, but this is like the only game that we've done it in like a really long time, as I think that's Klay Thompson pulling that up and knocking it down. It's just not even fair when you have to splash triplets on the field, including Denny Tyson into that family, as Mo Williams comes out the bench and knocks that down. Mo is coming out the bench for this team in 2K as he finds Zach Randolph. Randolph putting that one up and getting it to go. So, as you guys saw in the beginning of the video, as Steph Curry is going to pull up this three-pointer here and beat the buzzer, as Steph usually does. We got the shoe deal done. I'm gonna let you guys see those shoes at the end of the video. There's gonna be a commercial, like an actual commercial that 2K has together, where my player's in it and stuff like that. So you guys can see that at the end of the video, and you guys can see the shoes. I didn't really spend too much time making the shoe. I think I spent like 5 minutes on that shoe thing. Like, I just wanted to play the next game. You know, I wasn't really that into putting the shoe on, especially since like I heard that you can't even like use your shoe in like my career. Like, you can't even wear your own shoes. So, what's the point of even like spending too much time on this? Steph Curry hitting the fadeaway there at the end of the buzzer. I'm just looking for Steph at the end of the shot clock situations, because I want to lower my field goal percentage. And Steph actually raises his field goal percentage at the end of the shot clock more often than not, as he knocks down that three once again. End of the shot clock. Look at Curry. Look at the route runner this dude is, man. He's got 99 route running. Unfortunately, he couldn't knock down the three to give us the lead at the end of the buzzer there. But, I mean, that dude was just going zigging and zagging, and it's kind of unfair. I just make that dude run around in circles until he gets open. But unfortunately, Mike Conley rips me, and I'm trying to make up for it, and we get the chase down block on Conley right there, trying to start a fast break to Iguodala, trying to get him to look for me, and I'm just pulling up this jumper. I'm feeling myself, but we can't get it to go. But still, an unbelievable chase down block here. We're getting the steal, and I'm looking to lob it up to Iguodala, and Iggy puts that one down. Unfortunately, though, I am struggling, especially shooting for the most part in this game. Part of it's Conley's defense, part of it's just me not making too many open shots. As we find Iguodala, who's been pretty good lately in the offensive end, he gets that 3-pointer to go right there to give us the lead. You see Iggy 4-for-9 this game in double digits, as Tayshaun Prince knocking down the three right back at him. But yeah, Iggy's been pretty good lately. He's skinned at the go. But yeah, I am struggling. We got 12 assists, so thankfully I'm finding my teammates and they're knocking down shots as I take it all the way to the rim. Unfortunately, not able to get the go. Trying to at least draw the contact, but we do get the offensive rebound. I bounce past it to Iggy, and I was hoping Iggy would shoot it because he was definitely feeling himself, but he did not. Instead, here I am pulling up the three and not able to get the go. The 3-point shooting was a struggle in this game as we bounce past it to Klay Thompson, who drives it on Gasol and dunks it on him right there. But we are in a quite a battle right now. Part of the problem is Marc Gasol is making every single shot he attempts. As Denny, that's the way I gotta score, man. I gotta take it to the cup. Problem is, it's hard to take it to the cup with Gasol in the paint right there. Conley gets the and one, drawing the fourth foul on Danny Tice. I'm trying to get these steals out here. And part of that's getting a little bit too reachy. And that's the result you pay for that. And we are not even in double-digit scoring here as we're heading to the fourth quarter soon as Steph Curry rattling that one in. It took a few bounces, but thankfully it stayed in the cup. It went down. It continues to be a back-and-forth game. Harrison Barnes looking to get us back the lead. He does right there. It's been like, what, 10 lead changes in the second half alone so far as Draymond Green trying to get the steal almost did instead. I believe it's Courtney Lee. Yeah, Courtney Lee beating the buzzer right there as I'm looking upfield. I see Steph Curry unguarded for whatever reason, but Steph actually misses the shot there. You don't want to do that too often, though. You don't want to leave Steph Curry wide open. You don't want to leave Denny wide open either, except for maybe today, because today I am struggling. 33% shooting as Mo Williams is going to try to get that shot and go off at the end of the shot clock. Not able to get it off, though. Well, he did get it off. He just couldn't make it thanks to the good defense. And we go to the bench to start the fourth quarter. We sit out the first 2.5 minutes, and we actually come back with the lead as Denny Tice dunks it there. So shout out to the bench mob for doing that for us. But unfortunately, once I came back in the game, it was the Marc Gasol show. Three straight possessions. Gasol went to the post and got a bucket, and we just couldn't do anything about it. You see, I'm trying to deny it, but I didn't do a good job there. But even then, Gasol is just putting these freaking moves on Bogey right now. Bogey cannot handle Gasol. I'm trying to steal the ball right here, do it whatever I can, but Gasol this time going to draw the foul. So we're going to need to triple team, quadruple team, whatever it takes. Gasol, unfortunately, Randolph gets the rebound and put back here after we played some pretty good Deion Connolly, and now the Grizzlies are back on top. But Denny Tice is going to end up on top of Z-Bo right there. Oh boy, Z-Bo just put his hands up. And you know how to say hand down, man down? Well, hands up, these are really much better, apparently. Tony Allen knocking down the three-pointer right there. Tony Allen, more known for his defense, but it's a clutch three right there to get his team tied back up in this game. And that one's going down. That's a perfect release right there. You got to love that green that gives us the lead. I tipped the pass, but they get to keep it. And instead, Z-Bo holding the ball, taking a pull-up jumper. Not able to get to go, but Z-Bo just bullying in the paint right there, getting that put back. And now it's back to a two-point game. Shot clock winding down. I'm trying to get Quinn to run around, but he doesn't, so I gotta take this shot myself. And the step back jumper goes for Tice, back to a 4-point game. Connolly calling for in the post, minute 18 left, trying to guard the baseline. He's gonna take it baseline. He hits the floater before it can even get in position. Just a crafty move there by Connolly. And now the Grizzlies trying to get a defensive stop. Quay Thompson to the paint, not able to get it to go. He tried to bully his way in and draw a foul. Instead, the Grizzlies a chance to tie the game or take the lead. Prince for the lead, not able to get it to go. That would have been a big time shot. Instead, the crowd just a little bit silent, and now they're completely silenced after Iguodala just took it all the way and dunked it over Z-Bo. Z-Bo's getting abused in this game. This is exactly the guy we want to hold the ball right now, Tony Allen. And Allen's taking a pull-up jumper, and he's not getting that to go. And that was exactly what we want them to do. We don't want, you know, Connolly having the ball. We don't want Z-Bo. We don't want Gasol. That's okay with us. Even Prince, that's okay. And with him taking two-point shots, they don't really have time to take two-point shots. They don't have any timeouts. They got sent to the free throw line. We knocked down both our free throws. It's going to take a miracle for the Grizzlies to come back in this game. I'm pressing Connolly, trying to make sure he can't even put up a good shot. He's able to find Allen. Allen doesn't even get to go. Even if he did, it doesn't matter. In the end, we do come through with the win. Tough game in the grindhouse, but, you know, we made the winning plays in the last few minutes. So, if you guys leave a like in the video, look at that shooting. I didn't shoot well. Leave a like in this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe for more NBA 2K15 micro games. And I'm going to leave you guys with that commercial where you guys will be able to see my Ronald McDonald looking shoes.
Being an elite athlete means getting there early, because you'll settle for nothing less than the best. It means repetition, doing the same things over and over again until they become second nature. And even when times are tough, it means not giving up and getting right back out there to keep your dream alive. Because you know you'll do whatever it takes to get to the top. And if you want to be the best, you can't forget about the details. And it all starts with the shoes.